Hello, my soccer universe, and welcome to the Bundesliga Austria and Germany edition, Germany and Austria, I should say, for this weekend, which was quite of a remarkable weekend in both leagues. I am wearing my new Köln Carnival jersey, the current one. Yes, Köln lost, and I typically don't wear the jersey of a team that lost, but A, they were wearing this yesterday, and B, I really want to show it off. It will probably, for many videos, replace the jersey back there, but I am a little bit worried about Köln, to be honest. Doesn't look all that bright at the moment. But let's talk headlines. Yes, Bayern dropping points, and we have a tight top because Dortmund and Leverkusen are moving up, so it's getting a little bit more packed on top. On the bottom, Mainz gets the first victory, which also makes things very, very interesting. And in Austria, we also, everything gets closer together. Everything's getting back because Salzburg lost for the first time. And none of the two teams behind couldn't really take advantage of that. So also, the leagues are tightening. So let's look at the results of this weekend. We had Leverkusen getting kind of a labored win at Bielefeld. Yes, they were the better team. They took a deserved lead through Leon Bailey, but then a horrible Radetzky on goal. I mean, there is a pass back to him, and you can see how the ball just jumps in front of him and, yeah, goes over and is absolutely crazy. And then it is Dragovic very late that gets the win for Leverkusen, which is huge for them in the table, as we'll see. Gladbach against Augsburg, they get an early goal and then just cannot convert their chances. And as is often happening, if you don't convert your chances, you end up conceding. And that's exactly what it did. Numerous chances. Augsburg really not being that much in the game. And then even with a man down, because Framberger, who just came on the 54th, has already had two yellows, 62nd, 66th, off he goes. But Caligiuri gets a late equalizer, which must be said probably was more on the lucky side of things. Now, on the lucky side, Bayern against Bremen was one of those. There are many. Bremen had many good chances. Of course, Bayern was the better team, always threatening. I think they hit the woodwork at least once. So you always had the feeling kind of it's only a matter of time until Bayern scores. But Werder Bremen stood soundly defensively. Lars counterattacks, had many chances to actually make the score even wider. That they get the Eggestein goal, and this is the brother of the last striker, older brother, in the 45th, was actually not undeserved. They were really well in the game, but you know, whenever you poke the dragon, you're kind of afraid of getting burned. And again, Coman gets the equalizer. It seemed like a foregone conclusion that Bayern is gonna win this game. However, Bremen hung in there. And even remarkably so, Bremen had, through Josh Sargent, one big chance where they should have probably gotten even a goal out of. So it ends 1-1. I think it's the fourth or fifth 1-1 in a row for Bremen. But coach said afterwards, this is the 1-1-1 where I'm absolutely happy about it, because a point in Munich, that's a big thing still. Hoffenheim-Stuttgart was also one of those crazy games. Stuttgart actually completely dominated the first half. And with the first chance, Hoffenheim takes the lead, but Gonzalez quickly thereafter. And then Wamangituka in the 27th turned the game around. It's 2-1 for Stuttgart. Second half, it seems like the playing field is tilted into one, because suddenly it was all Hoffenheim, especially over Kramaric, who sets up first Sessegnon in the 48th and then converts a penalty himself and turns the game around again. However, Kempf gets then, I would say, the deserved equalizer in the 93rd minute to make it 3-3. Stuttgart is a really exciting team to watch, and I'm very, very happy about it, I have to say. Schalke Wolfsburg 0-2. Schalke is just hopeless, I have to say. Frankfurt takes the lead against Leipzig. Was Lars the bad team, but I have to say the equalizer from Paulsen, that's a goal you should watch. I mean, a nice cross from Angelino, and he just puts his foot under really nice. Was not a great game, but you know, maybe Leipzig was a tad closer to winning it, but I think the draw was rather deserved. And then the late game I actually intended to watch but never got the chance to because the zone broke down on me, and then I for some reason I didn't manage to get two screens running at the same time. Anyway, the goal by Cunha after Luka Bakio assist, this was very quickly on the counter-attack. It was a really nice one, and you think Hatta playing in very interesting jerseys, kind of celebrating the fans. There was like all blue and there's the flag over a very interesting special jersey. Now, I think that's great, but interesting at least. And Hertha is doing a lot with the sponsorship since they don't have a big deal at the moment. So I actually like that too. So you think Hertha can get something against Dortmund because Bayern is drawing points. And you can see that all the teams, a lot of national team players were a little bit struggling this weekend. This went more or less throughout the leagues. A little bit, but especially in the Germany and all Austria. But then after the break, I think within less than 15 minutes, Haaland scores three, which in German language is called the pure hat trick, because it's all in one half and no one scores in between. That's the pure performance. And I actually learned, and now in the English language, they're not as strict, that a hat-trick is only that, only a pure hat-trick, where you score three in one half, uninterrupted. Haaland absolutely going nuts. Guerrero adds a fourth in the 70th. He himself, in the 79th, makes it 5-1. Makes it 5-2 because Cunha converted the penalty in between. But Dortmund, rather impressive. Mainz gets the first win in Freiburg of the season. And then I saw actually quite some of Köln, Berlin, and I have to say the best thing I can say is this jersey was worn and it has matching socks. It is an absolute gorgeous jersey, I have to say. But no, the two chances in the first half got converted through Avoni and then Skiri for Köln makes the equalizer after Duda assist. It was 0.7. each expected goals for 7. That didn't change in the second half. There were not many chances. However, there was a rather unnecessary penalty given away that Max Kruse, it is for saved. His first miss. I think he could have made a new Bundesliga record, but on the rebound, he scores the goal. And that is 2-1. I mean, Köln didn't even manage a shot on goal then, and Union, it was a really, really, really bad game that I just watched to enjoy these uniforms, to be honest. Other than that, I probably should have flipped away. I was really hoping that Köln gets at least a point, but no, it was not to be. It's 0.7 expected goals each on both sides. So with all that, we have the following standings. Bayern still up top, but you see Dortmund and Leverkusen just a point behind, and Leipzig only 2 points behind. So it's really, really, really tight. And for the first time this season, we have Bayern below 100% making it to the Champions League. And this is the lowest 68% chance of winning the championship. It's the lowest we had this season. We had it once before because everything is so tight. I mean, last week, I think it was almost the highest. Now it's at the lowest. Still, they are highly favored to win this championship. One would expect it there to be, with Dortmund given an outside chance. I think the rest is falling away at the moment. For the Champions League spots, also the top four seem kind of set because Gladbach is stuttering a little bit. On the bottom, I think Köln is still profiting from a very good rating. I honestly have to say they don't look good. And I think there will be a coaching change sooner or later coming, because they have not been winning for a long time. It's similar to Schalke, and I think they will need some. They look without ideas to us, and I'm always sad because Köln is a big city. It's a nice city, a team that should be playing with the Dortmunds, the Bayerns, and so on, but their management is one of the worst. And that it can go well, you see Leverkusen is just on the doorstep. I mean, it's more or less a suburb of Köln. So yeah, I never understood it, but hey, they produce at least wonderful jerseys. So, but you know, Bielefeld, Schalke, really low, look bad, and Mainz, yeah, also not quite out of it. It's a long season still to play. I really hope that at least Köln gets out of there, but that's my personal preference. I also wish that Schalke would get out of there because it's another team that I really like. So the table is a little bit hurting for me now. The next round is we start with Wolfsburg, Bremen, and then, you know, kind of typical Bundesliga round come there. Köln plays against Dortmund now, talking so much about them. Then we have a southern derby between Stuttgart and Bayern. I think that could be interesting. Gladbach, Schalke sounds like something, but we know that Schalke is horrible. I think Leverkusen, Hertha is also one that I find very interesting. Leipzig should not have much problems against a team that shouldn't exist in Bielefeld. Bielefeld conspiracy, look it up. Let's move to Austria. Also a super remarkable round because the only one top team, and they're not even in the top at the moment, is that Wolfsburg won 2-0 at Altach. Lask, I saw that game. This was one of those where in the first half you have numerous chances, you convert one. You should have been two, if not three. And then just one smidgen, Hartberg comes out. They smell, we only one down, we have a chance. And they get the first corner, and from that corner, Lukaneta, who is a former Lask player, scores the equalizer. And then Lask had also again a few chances. I mean, it took a while, but you know, laid on. I really thought they might make it. They didn't, and it ends 1-1. It's definitely points dropped. However, the silver lining is that at least we made the points. Salzburg found themselves 3-0 down in the second half to Sturm Graz, who really just counterattack after counterattack took them apart. And yes, Salzburg was saving a few players for the game against Bayern, namely Keuter, Ulmer, Kamara, and then Wöber also. So yeah, they played a very young team, and Sturm Graz took full advantage of that. A late goal in the 86th through Berberischer was too little, so it's 3-1 for Sturm. And then the craziest game of the weekend with, if you like defending, don't watch the highlights, but other than that, it is worth watching. The 4-3 between Ried and Rapid, and I have a colleague who is a big Ried fan, and I think a few weeks ago when they were suddenly last, he was very worried. I tell him, you will win against Hartberg, and then now you have the chance because there's so much Europa League. Maybe against Rapid it will be tough. No, it will not be, because Rapid is not a good team, especially if they cannot rely on their counter-attacking strategy. And this is what I call was the perfect game. We had four lead changes. Ried went down one goal, Knaz Müllner scored that one, then an own goal from Grahovac, and then before the break, Kreidel makes it 2-1 for Ried. Then by the 65th, again, there was an own goal in there to make it 3-2 for Rapid. But the guy, Rainer, in the 65th, who made the own goal, scored then the equalizer in the 71st, and then Marco Grull very late, who had been really, really good in this game, creating loads of chances, made it 4-3. Absolutely crazy game. On top of the table, again, everything is closer. I mean, we have now Salzburg 2 points ahead of Lask, 2 points ahead of Rapid. So that is nice. But you know, it's still Salzburg over everyone else to win the title. I also find it interesting that Austria did not have a good result. So I thought they might make it in the top six, but it doesn't look that way. Wolfsburg will get in there, I think, sooner or later. Sturm seems like will get in there. And then I think it's been some pertinent Austria, and we have to see where this will go. On the bottom, Admira, they had a short period where they were good, but I think at the moment they won't make it. The upcoming week, already today, we have some cup games. The Austrian Cup is a complete mess, but we have two games on Monday and one on Tuesday. They just squeezed it in. Then the game between Austria and Hartberg had to be postponed. This was on the day of the terrorist attack. So yeah, it's a little bit of a mess there. And the next round, we have the big one in Vienna, Rapid against Austria, although it's not a really good game at the moment. I think if you watch Salzburg, Sturm, Lask, Wolfsburg, if you would watch Austria, those are much more interesting games overall. Anyway, those are my few cents for the two Bundesligas. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, subscribe to my channel if you want to see more, and I will talk to you soon. Bye! Hey there, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, here are some videos and playlists that you might enjoy too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel and click the little bell icon, as it will remind you whenever something happens in my soccer universe. And with that, have a wonderful day. Bye.